Good morning, Marble Falls Mustangs. It's Wednesday, April 8th, 2020, and it's time for your morning announcements. So rise with us and we'll get started with the pledges.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Mustang pride begins with me. I'm a learner today, a leader tomorrow, and a Mustang forever.
Happy hump day, Mustangs. Welcome back. We made it to Wednesday, middle of the week. How you feeling? Feeling like this guy? Tired and just kind of over it? That's perfectly okay. Yesterday, if you missed those announcements, we were out in Spicewood. We went to see the bald eagles. We got out, had some fresh air and sunshine, some beautiful countryside. Pretty blue bonnets, a running stream, a creek. I heard from one of our very own students that's their family's property, and she's been swimming in that creek her whole life. That was a really cool connection to make with her when she saw that on the announcement. So very cool. I didn't ask if I could share that, so I'm not going to say her name. But anyway, yesterday was a lot of fun, and I was thinking, okay, what am I going to do the next day? How am I going to top that? And you know what? It's just not always going to be that way. One of the things that we've talked about a lot as I've been doing these announcements is living in this new normal, living in this crazy time where, you know, day to day, the news changes and our feelings about what we're living through change, and even hour to hour or minute to minute. And today, my accomplishment is my dog is fed, my bed is made, I have on clothes and makeup, and maybe that's as far as we get, but that's okay. I just want everybody to know that whatever you're feeling is the perfectly acceptable way to feel right now, whatever that is. And in an hour, it may change. What I don't want you to feel is like you're alone. I don't want you to feel like there isn't anybody to talk to, that you're isolated, that you're going through this on your own, or that nobody understands or appreciates or can feel your struggle. Please reach out. If you're feeling that way, please reach out. I've had some great phone and email conversations and even some Zooms with both students and teachers and adults and parents who just are kind of feeling like they're all over the place and they think that there's something wrong with that. And really, there's nothing wrong with that. That's a perfectly normal way to feel. If you could go into a shelter at home quarantine pandemic and just feel like you're just rolling along like you always have, props to you, because this is a strange and unusual time. So if you're feeling strange and unusual from one minute to the next, and some days are better than others, and some moments are better than others, then just know it's normal and you're not alone. So I just wanted to reiterate that. And now this guy's dreaming, so obviously my delivery is incredibly compelling to him, that he can not only sleep through it, but go into deep dreams. Anyway, enough about that. I need to apologize to Cameron Ivy. I missed that birthday yesterday. I'm so sorry, Cameron. I hope you had a great day. And today we're celebrating three more today. Kale Buell, Charlea Willie, and Jace Williams. Happy birthday to y'all, guys. I hope you find a way to celebrate and feel honored and special on your birthday today. A few quick announcements. The Learning Hub is up and running. Thank you to Miss Bernard for her hard work on getting that going. And if you haven't seen it or know what it is an excellent way to find everything you need about remote learning while we are away from school. So if you go to the Marble Falls Middle School website or even the main district website and then find your way to our site, you'll see a red click here button and a banner at the top, and you can click there and it will take you to all of your information, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade, and STEAM, all of the elective classes, all of the core classes. You can find your weekly schedule. You can print that out. You can, keep that on your desk or share it with mom and dad so that they know what's going on. information about COVID-19 and what the latest updates are affecting us being out of school. All of that in one central place, plus contact information, how to get in touch with any of your teachers by email, how to get in touch with the counselors or any other administrators on campus. So it's a great kind of clearinghouse where everything is in one place and you can find everything you need. So please check that out. There's also a link to the announcement so you can see me and Jake if you've missed any of those. I just wanted to give a shout out to Ms. Bernard for doing a great job on that. And I hope that you'll spread the word and let everybody know about it. And the other big announcement, please don't forget, every one of you that is enrolled in Marble Falls ISD is eligible for the lunch pickup every day from 11:30 to 1 at the concession stand at the Marble Falls Middle School football field. So in the back behind the school where the football field is, the concession stand that's on the in that far end zone, 11:30 to 1. It's a twofer, so you'll get lunch for today and breakfast for the next day, Monday through Friday. Free and reduced or regular lunch, doesn't matter. Every kid enrolled in the school district, there's an email that's gone out on your behalf that verifies that you're enrolled in the school district and eligible for that pickup. You don't have to be present to do that. An adult, a caregiver, babysitter, guardian, anybody that has that email and can verify can go and pick up those lunches for you. So I just want everybody to know that and to take advantage of that. If you need additional help, if there are other siblings that are not in school yet, or if you're struggling with utilities, basic necessities, needing food more so than just the breakfast and lunch, if you're not able to access any of the hotspots or Wi-Fi locations for internet access and you don't have it at home, please reach out. Email your counselor and let us know so that we can put you in touch with additional resources, because we don't want anybody to be hungry. We don't want anybody to be trying to log on and do schoolwork that's not able to get into their Google Classroom or check in with their teachers. So please, please, please reach out to us. Email one of us, and on the Learning Hub, all that information is there so that we know. And if you know of somebody that hasn't seen these announcements or doesn't have internet access to get on to the Learning Hub to get that information, please put us make one of us aware so that we can get in touch with them, their parent, and get them the additional resources that are available to them. Okay? That's all I have for today. So I'm going to quickly run through our quarantine questions again. I got a lot of feedback that y'all like these, and maybe I'll try to include a screenshot if I get super editing fancy and can do that. Number one, something you're grateful for today. Number two, who are you checking in on or connecting with today? Number three, what expectation of normal are you letting go of? That's a big one. That's a really big one. We sometimes add to our own frustration by holding on to the idea of what was instead of what currently is. Living in the present and being in that mindset that just because I used to do it a certain way or just because things used to be a certain way doesn't mean that that's going to work today or right now. And I might need to let go of that, at least for the time being. So that's a big one. How are you getting outside today? I don't care how. Just find some time to get a little bit of fresh air, take a walk. Walk the dog, ride your skateboard, walk to the mailbox, move your body. That's another big one. 20 to 30 minutes would be ideal. Just start doing something fun. Don't think of it as exercise. You'll feel better as a result of it. And last but not least, cultivate some beauty in the world. Bake something, cook something, draw something, paint something. I planted some flowers. What did we do? Oh, we dug in the dirt. We did... did a little bit of yard work. It doesn't really show, but you know, it made me feel better just to get out and to try to pretty up my surroundings a little bit. So those are the six things, and I'll try to get a screenshot up for y'all just to for you to have for the future. But that's all I have for today. Jake, you gonna wake up and say bye? You gonna say goodbye? Nope. Y'all make it a great Wednesday, and I'll see you back here tomorrow morning, and go get a Mustangs.